Hi, I'm Tom Darling. I'm the High Performance Director for U.S. Rowing for Paralympic Rowers. I was recently hired by U.S. Rowing to guide the continued development of our pararowing team and head the U.S. effort toward the 2016 Paralympic Games in Rio de Janeiro, Brazil. What we're hoping to do is build and develop a sustainable pipeline of new and current U.S. pararowing athletes and place them in the right situations to train to become competitive in international competition and to win medals in 2016. U.S. Rowing has been involved in Paralympic rowing since it was included in the FISA World Championships and the 2008 Paralympic Games in Beijing. We have and have had competitive athletes in the system and have won 3 Paralympic medals, 2 in 2008 and 1 in 2012, and at this year's World Championships in South Korea, our leg, trunk, and arms double won bronze medal. But we want to be better, and I'm looking to develop the athletes that we have while looking for potential athletes among our wounded war veterans and newly injured individuals who have the ability to be athletes, were athletes, before they were injured and are already involved in another form of para sports. I could talk about these athletes, where they're from, and why they got involved, but I think it's better to hear it from the athletes themselves.
I was a victim of an IED blast. It resulted in double above knee amputations of both my legs. I went to Bethesda Naval Hospital first, transferred over to Walter Reed to do my physical rehabilitation. And part of that, I picked up the sport of rowing and decided to try and compete in it, and here we are. It was really, really satisfying to be able to train for something and then test yourself against the best people in the world. So it was a really good experience for me.
Yeah, whenever you're in a situation where a lot of the stuff that you're planning on doing kind of becomes not doable anymore, you have to figure out what you want to do next.
I discovered para rowing in early 2011. I was looking for a sport to do because it was one of the things that I missed was being able to train and compete in something. And I just kind of looked up rowing on Google, trying to see if I could learn somewhere in Washington, D.C. And there was a place where I could learn in Washington, D.C., and I started training. And they told me that I had natural ability, which I'm not really sure if they were BSing me or if they were actually meant it. But I believed them, so I kept training, and turned out I was good enough to try for the national team, and then we were good enough together to go to the Paralympics and keep going.
What drives me in life and sports, or really anything I do, is just wanting to improve myself and find out how good I can be at a sport or at whatever I'm doing. And I just want to keep improving myself throughout my entire life.
I was originally born in Ukraine, and I was adopted when I was 7 and a half, and when I was adopted, my mom, well, I had my first leg amputated after my first year being in America, and then my second one when I was 14-ish. I've always been a pretty active person, and I've always liked to compete, so naturally I feel like the athletics fit in really naturally with my lifestyle or what I want to do. And getting into rowing was a good way to test my, I guess, ability. I don't know, athleticness. I mean, it depends on what kind of person you are. If you're a very determined person, then you're going to, if you set your mind to something you want to do, you're always going to achieve it if you put in the hard work into it. And rowing's a good sport to do that in. Put in your work, like Rob was saying, and then like see where you stack up internationally and against the best of the best in the world.
So I was injured in a motor vehicle accident in 1999. I was active duty Navy at the time, and I was actually training for a triathlon when I got hurt. So and I was fortunate enough to spend my rehab time at Walter Reed, where they kind of really pushed the fitness, getting back to life aspects of it. So almost immediately after I got hurt, I started skiing again. And through the skiing, I was introduced to the rowing program in D.C. and put a call in down to Washington. That's how I got on the water. But I've always been looking for opportunities to compete. I was very lucky. I immediately found a couple of really great mentors who told me that forward motion is the only option. So by the time I was out of surgery, out of that initial sort of post-injury the post-injury phase, I was kind of thrust right into planning for my future. I was discharged from the hospital in May and went back to law school in August, and mostly because people that cared about me told me I didn't have any other option. I needed to keep moving, and so transitioning back into kind of regular life so quickly kind of gave me the opportunities to get out and swim and exercise and do all the things that my friends and classmates were doing.
In terms of the growth of the Paralympic program, it has changed so much since that spring in 2006. It has become so much more competitive. It has become, the bar is raised every year, and it's been really fantastic to watch the growth of the program. It's changed so much. Now there's a Paralympic Training Center. Now there are adaptive programs all over the country developing athletes to go to selection camps, go to trials. So it's really been fantastic to see the changes. I often ask myself, why do I do this? Why do I put myself through this? What am I going after? What am I looking to prove? And, you know, rowing has helped me in a lot of ways deal with my blindness. I lost my sight at age 11 due to brain cancer. And so rowing and sports in general have really helped me to deal with my disability, have really helped me to accept who I am and really, really just feel good about my life and feel confident about what I'm doing and how I'm doing it. So to me, being a part of this program has been absolutely life-changing.
If you think you want to try rowing, or you are a coach involved in the physical rehabilitation of people you believe could be a good para-rowing athlete, please contact me. We'll find you a place to row and a coach to teach you. All you have to do is call or email me and we'll get you started.